Hello and welcome back to another episode of Attack of the B Team. If you guys think it's a little bit echoey today, it's because I'm in a different room and there's not much sound dampening around. Just a table and some walls. But I have a ton of things to show you guys today, and I'm going to try and get through as much as I can. I don't know if I've shown you guys this. This was the template for the bunker that I wanted to build out here, and I got some feedback from Conflict, and he said it was a bit plain. And looking at it, I sort of agree. So this is going to become a warehouse as such for us. I've had to, oops, bit of lag. Look at this guy. This is Rexy. Rexy doesn't like me too much because I'm going to take him down to 6 hearts and make him my own. But I had to convert this whole area into iron, and that used a lot of iron. He just dug, I had the iron around the edges, and he just dug down. So I had to put him in a safari ball. I'll just come down and show you. So he started digging the holes down, just walking around digging down. And I watched him do it for a little bit and went, this is not good. So I grabbed a safari ball and let's eat. And caught him. Someone's at the door. I'll be alright. Okay, I'm back. Just a delivery guy. No one important. So that's my stuff there. So this is where we had Steggy. Steggy followed me, if you guys saw at the end of my last video, home. So he is currently in a safari ball as well. A little bit of lag. Because I don't really want him teleporting all around after me. You guys probably just caught a glimpse of that. But I want to show you what I did load into the world. Ooh, that's down there. What I did come up with for the design, you can probably see part of it in the map. I really want this to load in. Come on, load in. Why are you not loading? Come on, there we go. Load in. This is our new bunker. So this is going to be the main hub. You guys can see redstone up there. I'm actually going to get rid of that and change it over. And we have something to show you guys over there, which could be the reason for a bit of the lag. Load in. There we go. So, Illuminor. You can see, that's a weird stone just floating there. As you can see, this has been dug out quite a bit. Is that an actual bat, or is that someone else online? Come here. No, I'd say it's an actual bat. Yeah, bat. So we're going to go down, and Mitch and Rapid have actually joined in to help us with this, because it is a massive project. You guys are probably wondering about this, but I'm going to show you guys the inside first. So in here, very bland at the moment. Conflict has set up a waypoint. I'm not entirely sure how these things work, since because I used one and crashed the server last time. These are our batteries. And as you can see, they are all charged up. We have a deep storage unit here, and it has nearly 8,000 coal in it. Oops, lag. Yeah. This is also full of coal, which I probably should transfer into there. And these are just some other boxes with stuff left over in it from stuff we were doing. So, you guys might notice the symbol, which is cool. What's even cooler? Flip this switch. Boom! If we had a helicopter or something, we could land it straight in here. That's the advanced drawbridges, and they are awesome. I did have to design this pattern within them though, and that wasn't too hard. I just drew it out and then mapped it out on the things. Whoa! Let's go back up. Let's go back a bit and then go up. So the other thing I wanted to do was when that gate opened, I wanted the floor to extend up and out so we'd have like a platform that we could look around. So I have this design here. It's a touch crude and could use some refining. But the only ones that don't work are the edge blocks, which we can solve. But this would go like this. So this just has dirt on it, so you'd know. And it does push you up. So then we could stand up here and go, "Wha ha ha," and look around and shoot and do whatever else we needed to do. Yoink. So I left that there to show you guys a little bit how the redstone works underneath. So we just have the signal running all around with the repeaters running in to turn off the torches, because when we turn the power off, these will turn off and allow these to turn back on, which then in turn power one of these guys, which then in turn power the block next to it as well, which is awesome. So that's cool. What else do I need? The most important thing, our engine. I used Gliss's idea because it's an awesome idea. You'll see some getting harvested here. So simple to set up, to the point where it didn't take as long as this redstone. I have a clip to show you guys afterwards in regards to that. But this is a tree farm, and basically the trees just go get. Let's just fly down here. Oops, shouldn't have come around that side. I think. There we go. So we have the planter. The planter has an emerald upgrade, so it goes to 11x11. And of course, we have the sapolines in there. That stuff is powered. We'll come over here first. We'll look at. We had to build this bunker because I kept getting blown up by creepers. So I wasted a whole crap load of hardened glass and put these up. So here we have a harvester, which said error for some reason. Are you okay? You're all good. We have the energy cells, which is charging this guy, and is also charging the sludge boiler over there, which I won't go near because it will hurt me. So the sludge is sending the items through these pipes, which is filling up very, very quickly. We are going to have to set up our item system very, very soon. And let's just get you like that. So these are some leftovers from the trees. So what happens is this harvests the trees, which sends into this box. So we have the blocks in here. This block, the box then sends it out through two tunnels. So if we empty hand, okay, I can do this. I really need to fly home and put my XP away before I die again. In here we have it set for the spruce wood, the birch wood, and the oak wood, and the apples, and some of these dyes, which we can convert to dyes, which is awesome. So that's whitelisted, and of course we have the redstone disabled. Through this one, it's just letting everything through. So it sort of just goes dong 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 and alternates between the two. So because of that, we have over 7,000 bits of wood. That's the oak, and not as much birch wood as I'd like, but that's okay. I think the majority of it does come down this way first, which then leads to this junction box. So we can open this box. So, see, there's apples in there. I don't want apples in there. Oh, a bit of rubber. Because there's rubber wood floating through. Okay. I'll tell you what, let's... Have we got an empty... Is lime empty? Yes. So let's just put all this stuff in here. Can't put backpacks in backpacks. Okay. And that'll do. So let's grab these all out of there. Grab the raw rubber and the rubber wood. Grab you. We're gonna have apples for days. Let's just come back up here and feed them into the. Let's go back in line. Nice and neat. Awesome. So this will, let's just get you out of our hand. This allows these saplings to travel through, but actually we have some different saplings now. So let's do this. Oh no, what have I done? Ah, it's backed up because it's full down there. Okay, let's do that. And I want you, I want you. I don't know why I still have them though. Yeah. Let's just quickly go down here and unclog the system. There we go. That'll start filling up again soon. The harvester's kicked back in. As you can see, it's gone from being red, so it's now unclogged. I will have to devise some system to prohibit that from happening anymore. I really would love to know if I can get more than 9 items flowing through there. I'll have to look into it. I should put them up. It's okay. And then through here, we just are allowing the 3 spruce wood. The reason I'm only allowing the 3 woods, and I could put rubber wood, I think, is they lead down to a bank of redstone furnaces. So basically, it just goes in a loop all the way around. These guys don't get used very much. I probably could up the rate of wood by stopping it going out the other way. But I don't really need to at the moment. So look, it's 64, so that's... Okay, why are you not going out? Okay, could be an issue here. Let's just have a look at you. You should be flowing out. I don't think you need... Oh, it's stupid dogs. I don't need pneumatic servos there. You should be flowing out just fine. I'm just going to go kill some dogs. And I'll be right back. Okay, and I'm back. This is very weird. All I did was obviously go out and yell at dogs, threaten to kill them as I usually do. I removed this pipe here and replaced it, and everything started flowing. So it's just one of those things that sometimes happens where you just need to take it out, put it back in, and everything flows again. So that's churning it out there. I'm hoping the wood is coming down to these guys. I'm just going to fly up. Because we did see it coming out of the box before. So you're banked up again. There's nothing in the chest. The harvester. Are we having an issue with the harvester? It does have power. Chest, and okay, nothing's grown. Let's go check on the, so this is the tree farm, obviously nothing's grown here. Why is there stone in there? We have a fertilizer, and that has the emerald upgrade. Oh, it's getting no fertilizer. Why is that? Output input, are you trying to tell me? Composter. Let's just put some torches down here. I haven't made an upgrade chip for this yet. But why are you... You don't need power. No, you don't. Why are you not... Ow. Hello. You guys might notice I have a steel sword now instead of my nice one. That's because I died. Stupid lag killed me. Okay, are you guys not... Okay, so you just aren't going near it. Alright, well, I'm going to have to make an upgrade chip for that, because as soon as the fertilizer gets a rocking, then these things are grow. Come on, everyone come over here. I wish I had some wheat, but I don't. Okay, so I'll have to do that. I don't have the materials on me in order to do that, so I'll just finish explaining the engine to you guys. So basically, when a tree grows, the harvester chops it down, sends the wood through to the furnaces. The furnaces are powered by the redstone energy conduit. So this makes charcoal. The charcoal then leaves there, comes down here. It also makes a byproduct of ash as well. So in here, obviously the chest, and that'll go pretty quickly. So what I have, what did he drop? Did he drop iron? Cool. I have this filtered to purely the charcoal. And the charcoal flows into the steam dynamos and has the constant charge, and we have the aqueous accumulators underneath them, which is awesome. Oh, I just heard some trees grow. So the other byproduct that comes out of this is wood ash, which is from the witchery, which is what you get from burning off the oak. So that flows down here and into this side of the chest. Hey buddy, you wanna come over here? Die. So it flows into this side of the chest. With a double chest, where the items go inside the chest depends on where you have the item duct situated. So here, these should not, they should be coming down here like so. So we only have 64 of them. We did have a ton more, but you guys will understand soon. I'll go to a clip and show you guys what happened here exactly. So basically, this pipe funnels down and comes into this side of the chest, as in it's like a acts like a single chest, and then it's extracted by these pipes and sent up to our deep storage unit up there. This piping is all super messy, and we're just waiting to see how we design down the bottom before we run the piping. This could all change. This will stay, but there'll be housing. We'll build a housing around this, this will all change as well, because this will then become tied into our item system, which we have to transport over. So obviously we have the piping coming over here for the chest, for the wood ash. So that's all pretty cool. So because we have so much stinking power now, we've got 7 of these guys all putting off 4,000 RF. We have a ton of junctions because this is going to power the whole thing. So we have this guy, he's relatively close to being full. He'll be full in a second. There you go. So he is powering the planter. Let's get out of there. What do we got? Okay, it's all full again. The planter, and also running down to the other battery, which splits off to power the sludge and the harvester. It's always, always good to have these at a junction. There seems to be an issue when they're not. That some things don't get charged and some things do. I can't explain it, but it has an out of 2,000 RF, so it more than charges enough for everything. And we have that running down here, obviously, to another cell, which powers the compost, which is processing the sludge, which we're going to have to upgrade. That then gets sent over to this guy, the fertilizer, and he spews forth and everything grows, which is awesome. Just fly up here. So that means we have an abundance of power, never ending basically, because that's just a big cycle. The saplings go in, regrows, the wood gets chopped, goes through, gets burnt, is charcoal, becomes power, which then powers everything. So we're set. We will never need power again. I do have the... How am I going to get in here? Good question. Oh, fell. My bad. Let's go up. And around. I'm getting shot at. And I did have these guys here. They look cool. But if we ever need to take a battery somewhere, you know, they're there, ready for us. So that's the new base. I'm going to change that redstone to the secret redstone, which is just... what is that? It's the camo and the zombie flesh. So seek... If I could spell... secret redstone, there we go, and that's just about around the redstone, and so it'll blend in. I'm also going to get a secret lever for there, so that'll be cool, so we can just, so this won't be hanging out here. We're also going to use, we have some of these left, we just made a bunch of them, we have 18 of these left, so we are going to have our doors done out of them as well. So there'll probably be a door here, and any door for a room, it will be there, and we're just going to have a, secret switch, just a beep beep, and they'll go up and down as we see fit. Not sure about this platform, if we're going to use it or not. There has been talk about not using it, but we will see. I'm not 100% convinced on it either. But this is the progress that we have made on the new base. I hope you guys enjoy it. And I am going to finish the episode by showing you how a lot of this got built and what happened to my floor and... Oh, shooting at me. And what happened to a lot of this piping. Where are you? I see you. Die, 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 die. Ugh, useless sword. In my next video, hopefully we'll have some of this stuff set up. And we're going to tame T-Rex, the big fella. I just need to make a diamond sword. Because you've got to take him down to 6 hearts with a normal sword. And then give him the... Oh, pardon me. The scarab or whatever you call it. That we have. So thank you very much for watching. Please leave a like, it helps me out greatly. Please subscribe. The more subscribers I get, the more keen I am to make videos. And I hope you guys enjoy. And I'll leave you with a clip on how downstairs got dug out. Alright guys, catch you later. Bye. I don't know if you can see what's in my hand right now. How fast can a bat fly?
They're pretty fast when it's been propelled by fucking TNT.
Should we or shouldn't we put this redstone torch down? As you can see, it's going.
I'd say shouldn't.
Conflict is inside, but that's not really an issue. That is leading to that TNT, which is gonna... I might lead a bit more just to make sure it goes off. Take you to there. Take you to there. Take you to there. Take you to Monkey Town.
It's gonna cause a serious lag. I watched a video where this guy set up a heap of them nukes on Feed the Beast Unleashed.
Yeah.
It like lagged out his single player world.
Is that your warning to me?
In vaults, you know, the vaults, I set off about 6 antimatter just mines. And it completely froze me up. Worse than 10. Yeah, that was only just 6, and that's like 10 times what a normal TNT does.
I found some aluminum ingots on the floor.
Oh, they're the ones I can't pick up because I'm full.
You might want to hop out just quickly.
I'm out.
Oh, you're out? Are you ready for this? Are you ready? Let's go burn. Did it send the signal down?
I don't think so. I think we failed.
Where did I fail? Oh, down
here. Oh, you missed one.
Oh, that's alright. I'll just get one of these.
Oh, dude, I need to get out of here. Ah, I'm stuck.
What's your point? I'm not going to leave this torch on while I do it, obviously. That would not be a smart thing to do. Oh, you put some redstone there.
Yeah. And it still did nothing.
Yeah, because I moved the torch. You ready?
I'm ready. It's not setting them off, dude.
What?
It actually has to, redstone has to actually touch it, I've found.
It is touching
it. Yeah, it has to be on top of it.
Alright. Take that down. Have you got redstone on you? Why can't I move? What is blocking me? There is some form of... Oh. The go down button, that's what's blocking me. It won't go over the top of him.
I don't know. Do you need a repeater next to it?
No.
Wow.
No. What the heck? We need... Oh, I know. Hang on. I got the perfect thing.
What? Have you got flint and steel?
Something even better.
Herpes?
Did you see what I threw on the floor?
User joined your channel.
No, what did you say? Oh, yes, I do see.
Hello, guys.
Holy crap!
Ow! Ow! Ow!
Dude,
did it? Oh no.
Yeah.
Where did it go? I've got some more on me, I think. Yeah, item
duck. Oh, it's blown up like all of the base.
Did it? No, oh jeez.
Yeah, it blew up all the factory blocks and everything. You're the worst demolition
what happened?
Expert ever.
I told you that it would blow up the base. I told you it would blow it all up.